Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Probably the most well-known of all the Jewish davening pieces is the Shema prayer. The Shema prayer actually has three paragraphs that follow that line, and they're each quotes from the Torah, and the third of those paragraphs comes from this week's Torah reading. In that Torah reading it says, V'asu lechem tzitzit, and you shall make fringes on the corners of your garments, oritim oto, and see it. Now this, of course, is the origin for the practice of putting on a talis. Oritim oto also tells us that because it has to be seen, the mitzvah is only fulfilled during the daylight hours. So you won't go into a davening service at night and see the kehillah, the people there, wearing a talis at night. Oritim oto and seeing it also is the origin for why some people who wear the inner garment with the fringes, the talit katan, why they leave them out so they can be seen in public because they want them to be seen. Now there's some people who also wear the talit katan, the fringes, and they tuck them into their pants because they want to be a little less religiously conspicuous. Historically, Jews would hide their tzitzit in their pants because it was dangerous to identify yourself as a Jew in public. Thankfully, it's much less threatening today. There's another element of talit that I have to raise. In many communities, women are starting to put on a talit. And the reaction is anger. The reaction is, why are you going against tradition? The reaction is, this is not a mitzvah for women, it's a mitzvah for men. Why are you trying to be like a man? Why can't you embrace your femininity? I'm now going to read from the most important codification of Jewish law in our tradition, the Shulchan Aruch, which was codified in the late 1500s, nearly 500 years ago. The Sephardi rabbi, Rabbi Yosef Karo, writes, women and slaves are exempt from the mitzvah of talit. But then the Ashkenazic rabbi, the great Rav Moshe Isserles from Poland, he writes, nevertheless, if they want to wrap in a talis and even bless on that act, they are permitted to do so. Not only may a woman put on a talit, but she can even say the bracha, which says, thank you, God, for making us holy by fulfilling your commandments. The commandment to put on talit. Now, what's fascinating is that Rav Moshe Isserles, the Ashkenazi rabbi, lived 500 years ago in Poland. Why would he even comment here that a woman could do so? Were it not for the fact that the question came up? Were it not for the fact that there were women in the community who wanted to put on a talis, and so the question was asked of the rabbi? And not only did he address the question, but he said a woman may do so with a bracha. So no matter what community we're part of, no matter what stream of Judaism we're doing, isn't it healthier, instead of beating our heads in anger, to embrace and be excited and exalt the fact that Jew, male or female, wants to get closer to God by fulfilling the commandments? It's right here. Knowledge is power. The Shulchan Aruch, Orach Chaim, Seif Yud Zayin, Siman Yud Zayin, Seif Bet. Orach Chaim 17:2. Take a look, all you naysayers. And for the rest of us, let's give a thumbs up to any Jew who's engaged. Shabbat Shalom.